Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to use a noise gate to clean up voiceover recordings for video. Noise gates provide a quick and easy way to remove noise and breath sounds between sentences without having to manually replace those sections with silence in your editing software. Noise gating also helps a lot if you apply it before a compressor, since adding a compressor to voiceover decreases the dynamic range, resulting in an overall increase in the noise level. For this video, we'll be doing all our audio recording in Reaper, but it can also be done in other programs like Adobe Audition or Audacity. I'm using this program since it's inexpensive to purchase and has a built-in noise gate with all the features we'll need. To be able to cut out the noise with the noise gate, we need to cover how each of these controls works. I've recorded a quick voiceover track that we'll edit, so let's play that back first. This is our sample voiceover project. We'll configure the noise gate to cut out noise between sentences, but not enable within a sentence. The five controls we'll go over are the threshold, pre-open, attack, hold, and release. The first control is the threshold. When working with the noise gate on voiceover, this is the most important setting to dial in properly. The threshold sets a level where the noise gate releases and allows the signal to pass through. Below this, we pretty much consider these sounds to be noise that we want to remove. It's important that our voice level crosses the threshold and remains above it. We don't want the level to drop below the threshold anytime we're speaking. It's best to try and eliminate as much background noise as possible to get that at a low level so that we can easily set the threshold. This is our sample voiceover project. We'll configure the noise gate to cut out noise between sentences, but not enable within a sentence. Next, we can adjust how the noise gate deactivates. When the threshold is reached, the attack sets how long the transition is when the noise gate deactivates. For voiceover, we'll want this to be fairly quick, but still give it about 5 milliseconds to avoid any popping from the immediate transition. Even at this speed, sometimes we can have it sound like the very beginning of words are cut off when the gate releases. That's what the pre-open is for. This acts as a look ahead and causes the gate to open before the threshold is reached. For example, I can set this to 10 milliseconds. It is possible to use a noise gate in programs without the look ahead option, but in that case, we have to set the attack pretty much at zero and lower the threshold more, making the gate more sensitive to small amounts of noise in the recording. This is our sample voiceover project. We'll configure the noise gate to cut out noise between sentences, but not enable within a sentence. In some cases, we might have the noise gate clamping down too quickly, especially on silence between words. We want to avoid this and only have it enable between sentences. To do this, we increase the hold time, and I usually set it to around 150 milliseconds. I find shorter than that and it enables too quickly or cuts off the end of words when the level drops, but any longer and relieving additional noise. I also set the release to around 35 milliseconds so it transitions out a bit but doesn't take too long. This is our sample voiceover project. We'll configure the noise gate to cut out noise between sentences, but not enable within a sentence. Thanks for checking out this video on using noise gates for voiceover. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for links to social media accounts to stay up to date on all our new content.